Today on Sesame Street, you'll meet a terrific teacher, some spectacular students, and a gaggle of goofy graduates. School sure is cool here on Sesame Street.
This is also exciting.
Yeah, because Elmo never knows who he'll meet on Sesame Street.
Remember when you two were side by side in baby carriages?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, one more group shot, okay?
You know what? I'm going to take it.
Yeah,
so you can be in it.
Good, good.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right. Ready? One, two, three.
Hey, hey, hey. What's going on, everybody? Hi.
Hi. Hello.
Why are Gabby and Miles wearing those bathrobes and funny hats?
Oh, it's a graduation robe, Elmo.
Mm-hmm. Miles and I are graduating high school today.
Oh. Huh?
Hey, you know what? I have to go get ready for the party, but who wants to see the cake?
Oh, I do.
Come on inside.
Okay, all right. Okay, guys, we're going to leave in 5 minutes, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Congratulations. We're so proud.
Thank you.
Gabby, Miles?
Yeah?
Elmo still doesn't understand. What's going on?
Well, when you finish high school, you have a celebration.
Oh.
And it's called graduation.
Ah, so it's like a party.
Well, sort of. We get to wear these caps and gowns.
Wow. Elmo loves the caps and the stringy things, too.
It's called a tassel.
Oh, really? Neat.
Yeah, and then our parents get to watch us walk up a stage and get a diploma.
A diploma?
Yeah, a diploma. See, that's a piece of paper that says you officially graduated high school.
Wow! Boy, Miles and Gabby are finished with school, and Elmo hasn't even started yet. Elmo can't wait to go to school.
You are going to love it, Elmo. You know, I remember my first day of school.
Me too. I was so excited.
Mm-hmm. And mi abuelita made me a new dress.
Mi abuelita?
And I had this new pencil case. Man, I love that pencil case.
I remember that.
Remember our classroom?
It was amazing, full of books and toys.
It was the most wonderful place I'd ever seen.
Tell Elmo more.
There was this huge basket full of blocks. We always used to build skyscrapers.
And a whole cupboard full of art supplies.
Okay. All right, children, everybody, would you please take a seat at one of the tables? Welcome to the first day of school. My name is Miss Walsh, and I'm your kindergarten teacher. And we're going to learn a lot of new things together, and we're going to have a great time. Now, who knows the alphabet song? Raise your hand. You do? Oh, wonderful. Then let's all sing it together. You can sing, too.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I've sung my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
That's excellent. Give yourselves a hand. Wonderful. Now, let's add some rhythm to it, okay?
Okay.
What do you say? Can we do that? Clap with me.
much fun. Do you remember that?
Emma was to have a teacher just like Miss Walsh.
Miles, hey. Gabby, it's almost time to go to the graduation.
Don't worry. We'll be right there, okay, Dad?
Great. Oh, that a boy. That's my boy.
Man.
I remember Miles was really, really shy when Miss Walsh called on you.
Oh, no, don't tell that part.
Yes, you just tell that part.
Miss Walsh asked us to draw a picture of something we really loved.
That's terrific.
I remember. Brian, I loved that bin full of crayons. It had every color you could imagine.
Triangle. Beautiful triangle. Nice colors. Okay, so raise your hand if you'd like to show the rest of the class your drawing. Gabby, let's see.
This is where I live. These are the front steps, and Oscar the grass is in this garbage can.
Ah, it's very interesting living next door to a grouch. And Miles? Oh, Miles, what a wonderful picture. All these great colors. What is the big orange circle?
A basketball.
Yeah? Are you feeling kind of shy?
Yes.
Well, that's okay, because I feel that way sometimes myself. What else? Is the basketball? That's the basketball. And what are those shiny dots?
Stars.
Stars. A basketball and stars.
It's wow. A basketball in space.
Oh, I see it.
And here's the moon, and over here is the sun.
Okay. And what's this? Is that the spaceship? Is that a spaceship?
This is the spaceship.
That's the spaceship.
And here's the galaxy, and over here is the spaceship. It's trying to land on the asteroid.
Oh, wow. That's terrific.
The spacemen are gonna play basketball on the asteroid.
I see.
And they're wearing special gravity sneakers.
Miles sure wasn't shy after that. You couldn't get him to stop talking.
Wow. What a great first day of school.
Yeah. Hey, Gabby, you remember we had an argument?
Really?
Yep, a big argument.
Hey, Miles, sweetie, we gotta get going.
But Emma wants to know about the argument.
Just one more minute, please.
Okay, but hurry up. We want to get some good seats.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, so what happened? What happened?
All right. Now, there was this big red fire truck, right?
Oh, Emma loves big red fire trucks.
Well, so did we.
I did.
Hey, what's the problem over here?
I wanted to play with the fire truck.
I want to.
It's mine.
Okay, hold it. Isn't there a way that you could both share the fire truck? Learning to share is a very important part of being in school. I share with you. You share. Is there a way that you can both share the fire truck?
I like to be the bell.
So do I.
I like to be the siren, too.
Hey! You could be the siren, and I could be the bell.
Oh, that's a great. How's that sound?
Yeah!
That's a great idea. And how does the bell sound?
Ding, ding.
And how's the siren sound? All right, go get him. Go ahead. Ding, 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 ding. Thank you for sharing.
We shared our first day of school together.
Now we're sharing our graduation.
Come on, honey, come on. You really gotta go.
Okay, Mom.
What's the matter with you two? You want to miss your own graduation?
Mom, she's right. Mm-hmm. We gotta go. Okay. Bye, Elmo.
Well, we'll see you at the party.
Wait, Miles. Miles, one more thing.
What's that?
Boy, Elmo just loves that tassel.
Okay, I gotta go, Elmo. Bye.
Thanks for telling Elmo all about your first day at school. Boy, someday, Elmo's going to go to school and graduate and have a gown and a hat and a tassel.
Okay, everyone. Can we get everyone's attention?
Atención, por favor.
Sí, señor.
Yes, Luis and I would just like to say,
as fathers of the graduates,
we could not be more proud of our son
and our daughter
than we are today.
And someday, Elmo's going to go to school and graduate, too.
Good for you, Elmo. Yeah.
And have a tassel.
All right, I'm going to take one picture of everybody, okay? So get together.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
All right, you look great. Ready? One, two, say graduation. Excellent.
Graduating today?
And wow, you know what? It's the graduation march of the penguins.
Congratulations, penguins! Elmo loves your tassels.
Up in the morning, off to school. We're riding the bus so calm and cool. There's lots of kids I'm getting to know. And the teacher smiles and says hello. There's tons of books and games to play. There's paint and paper and toys and clay. And everybody's getting a turn. There's so much interesting stuff to learn. Taking a rest, then getting real messy and cleaning the mess. We sit in a circle, we stand in line, and listen close, it's story time. I'm asking questions, raising my hand, and the teacher helps me understand. Tomorrow's my turn to show and tell, but bye for now, there goes the bell.
There, me here. Where everybody go? Oh, hi, me here today to show you letter of day. Yeah, ta-da, the letter P. Yeah, at least me dig it, letter P. Well, it sure look like letter P. Let me smell. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that smell like letter P. P. Yeah, sound like letter P. Me better taste to make sure. Mm-hmm. Nom.
Cookie Monster! Wait, please do not eat that letter P, Cookie. I need the letter P. P is the first letter of my name, Prairie.
Yeah, Yeah, that terrific prairie, but oh, me so hungry. Oh, me want to eat letter of day.
Cookie.
Hold me back. Hold
cookie.
Me back.
Cookie.
Me going to eat it.
Cookie. Put the letter cookie down. Come on.
Down?
Down.
Okay.
Good. Now come with me. I know exactly what to do.
Yeah, lead the way. No. Huh? Yeah, this blindfold, good idea, Prairie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Mm. Because if you cannot see the letter P cookie, then you will not eat it.
Yeah. Out of sight, out of mind.
Exactly. Well, see you later, Cookie.
Bye-bye, Prairie. Ah. What that? Me smell letter P cookie. Yep, that letter P, all right. Picant.
Just checking. It's gone. Oh, Cookie Monster. Did somebody eat the letter P, Cookie?
Me no see anybody eat letter P, Cookie.
Oh.
Me blindfolded, remember? Yeah.
Pathetic.
P. P. Plant. P plant.
Workout today, and you're here. Well, you're just in time to see the worms do their little workout. What's that, Slimy?
Sing the song.
Don't tell me you want me to sing the workout song.
Yes, please.
Oh, I hate doing this, but okay. Oh, the things a grouch will do for his worm.
Young worm, if you want to work out, I said young worm, there's no reason to shout. I said young worm, there are things you can do, and all you worms at home can do too. Stretch, wiggle, yay. Stretch, wiggle, yay. It will help you get strong, it will help you live long. Come
these worms. They're just looking too healthy and too happy. Had enough of this. Oh, out of here.
Wow, look at that.
What's the big deal? Some lady rowing a boat.
You think it's that easy?
I don't know.
You gotta be strong to row a boat like that.
I guess you're right.
I bet when she was a little girl, she did a lot of exercises. And I bet she ate a lot of healthy foods. Like fruits and vegetables and tofu.
Tofu? Ew.
Yeah, tofu's good for you. You ever tried it?
Well, no.
Then what do you know?
Well, did she play basketball?
Of course she did.
Man, she can move. I kind of like this painting.
I told ya. Come on, let's get something to eat.
Okay. Maybe some tofu.
Okay.
Hey, Ben.
Mm-hmm.
Let's eat a pretend healthy snack, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so Elmo has a tuna fish sandwich. What do you have?
Applesauce.
You have applesauce?
Mm-hmm.
Cool, where is it?
Right here.
Oh, there it is. Okay, well, you eat your applesauce, and Elmo will eat his tuna fish sandwich, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead. Elmo's got crumbs on him. What else do you have?
Apple.
Oh, yeah. That's a nice apple. Elmo has a pear. Ready to eat? Okay. Wow. Now that's a healthy snack. Kiss.
Bert. Bert. Bert? Hey, Bert.
What?
I was just thinking of some of the things you can do with your head, Bert.
Oh, yeah. Ernie.
You know, Bert, one of the things you can do with your head is to remember.
Oh.
You can remember with your head, Bert.
Great, great, Ernie.
And I was just thinking of some of the things that I remember best.
Great.
Things I really like to remember, Bert.
Things that I remember. Times that never end. Favorite things inside my head. Special friend to friend. Roads we've walked together. All the stops we've made. Jokes we've told and songs we've sung. The silly games we've played. And there are chilly days.
Never fell asleep.
from Jamaica, and boy, are my water wings tired! Ah ha ha ha! Jamaica is far away in the middle of the Caribbean Sea, and it is where I learned how to tie-dye t-shirts. See my tie-dye t-shirt? Wait a minute. Where's my shirt? I lost my shirt! I had it on in Jamaica. I have to find it so I can show it to you. I will look for it while my little friend tells you all about tie-dyeing. Watch this.
Painting time!
I live in Jamaica, a beautiful island in the Caribbean. Delicious fruits and beautiful flowers grow everywhere. The sun shines every day, and there are many friends to play with.
Living in Jamaica, little island on the rock.
Today, my neighbor Ozai is going to teach all the children how to make colorful designs on our t-shirts. We are going to learn to tie-dye. We were all given strings to tie around our shirts.
Everybody have a string?
Okay.
Right. Now let's begin.
The string must be tied very tight so the dye doesn't seep in.
Tie and dye, right?
Ozai made a fire to boil the water while we use balls and rocks to make different designs on our t-shirts. Shirts were all tied, we wet them in cold water.
Which color do you like?
The shirts stayed in the gold dye and then we rinsed them in cold water.
From the countryside and dudes from the town, dye and dyeing with the yellow and the brown.
After the shirts were dyed, we retied them. The next color we chose was red.
Said it's color time, said it's color time, said it's color time, color time, color time.
We put them in purple dye and then in green. I started to get nervous when the shirts turned all brown. But when we opened them, they were beautiful, as if someone had painted on them.
Every children love the paint of the red, gold, green.
We hung the shirts to dry and then put them on. I love my tie-dye t-shirt. It is the first shirt I ever made.
I did not find my t-shirt. I am so sad.
Hey, buddy, You lose a shirt in the ocean?
That's it, my tie-dye t-shirt! Is it not beautiful?
Oh, yeah, I like it. I really think it's me, dude.
It is you. I better go back to Jamaica and tie-dye another t-shirt for me.
Whoa, dude. Hey, there's no water here. I gotta get back to the ocean. Want a lift to Jamaica?
Yes, I would love a lift, thank you!
Okay, hop on. Dude, Don't wrinkle the shirt. It's an original.
Oh, sorry.
Countess, my little sucker toss. It is now time for us to reveal the number of the day.
Ah, yes. You will count, mein Schnitzel, until I shout, stop!
Be still, my heart. And that will be the number of the day. Hit it, Mike.
Number of the day. Number of the day. Number of the day of the day of the day.
Hey, hey, hey.
Is it one? Is it two? Is it three? Is it four? Is it five? Is it six? Is it seven? 'Twill be great if it's eight and divine, if it's nine or ten or even 11. Could it be 12 or maybe 13 or even 14? Can begin a begin? Is it 15?
Stop!
the number of the day.
Please type the number 15.
15?
Where is another 15?
15?
Try again.
15!
You can win 15 flying fish.
15!
I go counting to 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Well, go on.
Who are you?
Who am I? I'm the number that comes after 14. I'm 15.
So that's what you look like. Every time I try to count to 20, I forget all about you.
Oh, you're not alone. You probably don't realize this, but of all the numbers from 1 to 20, I'm the one that's hardest to remember.
Please tell me why you pass me by. You remember every other team. You always skip me. Thank you. Hey, where's Mr. Noodle?
pajamas.
You're not ready? Oh. No, no, Mr. Noodle, come back.
He's not dressed.
Ah, that's the question, Mr. Noodle.
Get dressed, Mr. Noodle.
Well, how do you get dressed? And you're getting dressed.
He's got a shirt on.
You're not finished, Mr. Noodle. There's more. Your shirt's not buttoned all the way, Mr. Noodle.
Button the top of the shirt.
Mr. Noodle, that's already buttoned, Mr. Noodle.
Button the top of the shirt.
You button your shirt. Mr. Noodle.
What about your tie?
Do your tie.
Watch out for your collars.
That looks good.
Very good, Mr. Noodle. What happened to his shirt?
It's sticking up.
That's okay, Mr. Noodle. Roll it down. Roll it down, Mr. Noodle. Oh, now, put on your pants, Mr. Noodle.
You need pants, Mr. Noodle.
Yeah, your pants.
No.
On your leg.
Not on your arms, Mr. Noodle.
Your pants go on your legs.
On your leg.
Yeah, on your leg.
No, only
one leg at a time.
You're doing it wrong.
He looks like a penguin.
Put one leg in, then the other leg in.
That's it!
Oh, those are big pants.
Use the suspenders.
The suspenders.
The suspenders will hold your pants up. You can do it. Yeah, Mr. Noodle.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
He's all dressed.
Now you're all dressed. You look great, Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle sure does have bouncy clothes. What's that, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you get dressed?
Hi, Dorothy, this is how I put on my socks. First, you pull it up. Then you pull it down. Now I do the other one. You pull it up again. And then you pull it down. And that's how you do it, Dorothy.
When it's cold, I put on my sweatshirt like this, Dorothy. First, I pull it over my head. Then I put one arm through. And then I put the other arm through. See? Like that, Dorothy.
This is how you put on snow pants, Dorothy. First, you put one leg in. Then you put your other leg in. Then you tuck your shirt in. You snap it. Zipper it. Then you tighten it. That's how you put on snow pants, Dorothy.
Thanks, kids. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo is going to ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. How do you get dressed, baby? Thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yes, you. How many pairs of pants are marching by? Let's count them and see.
One. Two.
Everybody, and now
Elmo has mail. Elmo has
Elmo has mail.
Elmo would like to get his email, please.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, good. Oh, it's email from Elmo's friend Ernie.
Hi there, Elmo. Rubber Ducky wanted to tell you that he likes getting dressed sometimes. Mm-hmm. What's that, Rubber Ducky? Oh, okay. He's still getting dressed. Okay, Rubber Ducky. He's dressed now. He's dressed as a police officer. See his little blue police shirt and tie and his little police hat? Officer Ducky, you are a credit to your community. What's that, Officer Ducky? Oh, Officer Ducky says, let's quack this case. Oh, that Officer Ducky, he never misses a beat. Bye-bye, Elmo. Say goodbye.
Good night. Thanks, computer. Police officers wear blue shirts and ties when they get dressed for their jobs. That makes Elmo wonder. What do other people wear when they get dressed for their jobs? Elmo wants to know. Don't you? Let's find out. Draw a little help. A little help. What do firefighters wear when they get dressed to put out fires? A bathing suit?
No.
A tutu?
No.
A firefighter's uniform?
Yes.
To protect them.
Yeah. A firefighter gets dressed in a firefighter's uniform. What do astronauts wear when they get dressed to go into space? A scuba diving suit?
No.
A baseball uniform?
No.
A space suit?
Yes.
An astronaut gets dressed in a space suit. What do worms wear when they get dressed?
Worms don't get dressed.
Unless it's slimy, and he can wear whatever he wants. Looking good, Slimy. But it's still eat your heart out. thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Alexis gets dressed all by herself. And then she helps her baby sister get dressed, too. And she told Elmo all about it.
I'm 7 years old, and I can get dressed all by myself. It's easy. But my sister Ariana is a baby, and babies are too little to dress themselves. Sometimes I help Ariana get dressed. First, my dad changes Ariana's diapers. Babies wear diapers. Then I put on her t-shirt. Sometimes we play. Where is Ariana?
Where's Ariana?
There she is. We help Ariana put her arms through the sleeves. Then we put on her overalls. They have snaps.
They can be kind of tricky.
Babies have really little feet.
Ariana's favorite socks
have butterflies and numbers on them. Then we put on her shoes. There she is, dressed up and ready to go. Someday, Ariana will be old enough to get dressed all by herself. But until then, I'll be here to help her.
Nice job, Alexis! Now, Elmo wants to learn even more about getting dressed, don't you? How can we learn more? Yeah! We can watch the Getting Dressed channel. Hey, even TV got dressed today. Well, turn around and let us see you, TV. Oh, wow. TV looks very nice. Turn yourself on.
Welcome to the Getting Dressed channel.
We're a really great outfit.
Now it's time for a song about getting dressed.
I love getting dressed. If you love getting dressed, then I got a song that'll knock your socks off. Come on, let's sing and get dressed. If you've already dressed, you can pretend to get dressed. I put my legs in my pants. I put my legs in my pants. You put your legs in your pants, you'll be doing a dance.
Next on the Getting Dressed channel, Socks and the City, followed by Shall We Pants, starring Shirt Reynolds.
There's a TV.
Thank you. Oh, look. Elmo got dressed with the song. But Elmo still wants to learn more about getting dressed. How can Elmo find out more?
Why not look in a book?
Read the book. Oh, yeah, can book tell Elmo more about getting dressed?
Sure. My title is The History of Getting Dressed.
Oh, boy! Open up and let's see what's inside, Book.
Okay. Back in cave person days, people got dressed in cave person clothes.
Wow! A dressed cave person!
Later in ancient Rome, people got dressed in togas.
Elmo dressed in a toga. Toga! 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 Toga!
In medieval times, people got dressed in clothes made of metal. They were called knights in shining armor. In Scotland, people got dressed in skirts called kilts. And they still do.
Book knows a lot about getting dressed.
Well, I try to cover everything.
Elmo loves getting dressed. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the Getting Dressed song.
Hey, I love that song. May I join in?
Sure. Here we go.
Getting dressed, getting dressed, getting dressed.
Sing along if you want.
Getting dressed.
Say goodbye, Bob.
Goodbye.
Let's do it.
Bye, Book again.
Bye. Story time.
Yeah, Slimy, it is story time. So, which grouchy bedtime story will it be tonight? We got the Brat in the Hat.
No.
All right. Let's try Get Lost, Moon.
No.
Okay, then We got the very angry caterpillar.
No. Right? Trash Gordon!
Oh,
Trash Gordon!
He always goes for Trash Gordon.
Yeah.
All right, if that's what you want.
Yeah.
Let's see what adventures we have in store for us tonight. Okay, chapter 241 in The Adventures of Trash Gordon. When we last left our hero, Trash Gordon, he had landed on the noisiest planet in the galaxy, the planet Pots and Pans, where the Pots and Pansians were banging on Pots and Pans. Man, what a racket. Luckily, our hero was prepared. He took out the biggest tops of the biggest pots under the sun and banged them together. It was the pot heard round the world. The Pots and Pansians dropped everything, covered their ears, and scrammed. That's when our hero heroically said,
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter P and by the number 15.
Hooray! Another story, please. Please.
No, sorry there, Slimester. It's time for you to go to sleep. We'll read some more trash tomorrow, or whatever else you want to read.
Okay,
now, see, here you go. Okay, get comfy, drift off to dreamland. So many books, so little time.
Thank you.